name is Alina, and I'm an international student visiting The Hague. This week, I'm going to the International Criminal Court to discover how it is addressing sexual and gender-based crimes.
The court is focusing on crimes of sexual violence and gender crimes, and already we have one very important jurisprudence on this case. The Bemba case is a remarkable case in relation to sexual violence. Basically, the prosecutor focused their case on the amount and the extent of the sexual violence that was committed. As it was recognized in this judgment, rape was not only for satisfaction, but was a tool of war. There is a case of a father living in a compound where he lived with his wives, with his children and grandchildren. The soldiers, many soldiers, enter the compound. They rape one of his wives. They rape his granddaughter that was between 10 to 12 years of age. Then they rape his daughter. Then they rape two of his other daughters that were also between 14 to 16 years of age. And then, that was not enough, they also rape him in front of his family, in front of the neighbors. When they discuss this type of crimes, you have to also have in mind the cultural context. These crimes were committed in the Central African Republic, and they were committed against, as I said, women, men, and children. Some of the witnesses, for example, the man I told you a story, he said, I'm a dead man. One of his wife left him because he said, you're not a man anymore. But as it is difficult for us to talk about that, for them it's exactly even or more difficult to talk. Still nowadays, crimes, gender crimes and sexual crimes are extremely underreported. Not prosecuted in every case, but not even reported by the victims or their families because of the impact that will have. We show them a body and they have to mark. So this person here mark the parts of his body. This was a man that were attacked. So this is a witness. So he marked the first person raping him with this and this and this. And then the second with this. With this, we have the sufficient evidence, or the prosecutor can prove the case and the judges can finally decide whether or not this person was raped, because you need to have that element proven in court.
If this issue is important to you, please like and share this video with your friends. Stay tuned and join us for our next interview with an officer from the ICC's Office of the Prosecutor.